I'm Olivier Marlet, and I will present you a semantic web platform for interoperable archaeological data called OpenArchaeo. This is a collaborative work with Béatrice Markov, Xavier Rodier, and Thomas Francard. Since 2013, the MASA Consortium, Mémoire des archéologues et des sites archéologiques of the French Very Large Research Infrastructure, Humanum, has assisted archaeologists in digitizing and making available their excavations archives. The objective of the, is to make these archaeological datasets interoperable with following the precepts of the FAIR principles. First step was online availability and usability of datasets. Second step was to make them interoperable, which required a shared communication layer. For this purpose, the MASA consortium chose the standard ontology CIDOC-CRM, dedicated to the modeling of cultural heritage. This ontology is increasingly adopted by the large by large libraries like, such as the Bibliothèque Nationale de France, by museums like the British Museum, for example, and in European projects, Ariane Plus, of course. In the context of Ariane Plus, the MASA consortium is engaged to share its datasets together with OpenArchaeo, an experimental tools which have been devised for exploiting them. More and more projects have mapped older datasets to CIDOC-CRM for interoperability purposes. It's now necessary to have intuitive search tools to explore these interconnected datasets. The MASA consortium proposes that OpenArchaeo build this tool for the archaeological community. It provides an online interface for querying several archaeological datasets, meeting the needs of a user-friendly query interface, the use of external tesserae and API for web services. Thus, OpenArchaeo is a way for exploring data from distributed autonomous data providers without duplicating all data by locally loading it. OpenArchaeo is developed by the Laboratoire Archéologie et Territoire with the Spanner Company for the consortium MASA. We devise interfaces for applications, for administrators, and for end users. OpenArchaeo's end users are archaeologists, whether researchers or amateurs alike, that is, people who know what an excavation is. For such people, we soon realized that the same generic model we built as a guide for mapping excavation data to the CIDOC-CRM should be the right conceptual model for guiding the querying of this data. The mapping of archaeological databases to the CIDOC-CRM is a prerequisite for their interoperability. Many tools are currently available to perform this operation, depending on the existing database format. The first dataset to integrate OpenArchaeo is ARSOL, the Laboratoire Archéologie et Territoire Relational Database for Excavation Data Management and Research, created in 1990 and available online since 2014. For ARSOL, we use ONTOP, an ontology-based data access tool designed at the University of Bozen-Bolzano, which enables us to define mappings with a protégé plugin. Those mappings can be used either to directly query the CIDOC ontology and get used from the connected relational database or to explore the relational database into our RDRF graph or CIDOC-CRM instances. The second database is an XML dataset, AERBA, the Atlas of Rural Settlements in Ancient Bones in France. For this second dataset, we used the Mapping Memory Manager, the online visual application provided by ICS4's team in Heraklion to map an XML dataset to the CIDOC-CRM. In both cases, the generic data model extracted from CIDOC-CRM and its extensions has been implemented, establishing the minimum elements that can be found in most archaeological datasets, even at different scales. The same generic model is currently used by the MOM, Maison de l'Orient et de la Méditerranée, Lyon, France, for mapping their data on excavations of the Kition Pervolia site in Cyprus to the CIDOC-CRM in order to add it to OpenArchaeo. This model is a selection of Cydox CRM, Cydox CRM Science and CRM Archeo entities and properties that are necessary and sufficient for representing the core of excavation data. It's important to notice that our objective is to federate several autonomous datasets, and Open Archeo platform is not intended to provide access to all specific elements to each corpus. It is therefore not necessary to perform a completely detailed mapping of each dataset to the Cydox CRM ecosystem. Its purpose is to answer fairly simple queries and to provide in the answers the URLs to access the detailed records in each data source. If a source handles specific issues, it's by switching from the results given by Open Archaeology to the online database of this source that the researcher is able to query the specificities more accurately. Thus, the queries concern a general level that is common to most archaeological datasets. This level concerns the site, its location, and the person in charge of the operation, the structures, features, walls, burials, stratigraphic units, and artifacts. For each of these items, attention has been paid to standard descriptions, possible dates, and the related documentation. Following the spirit of Cydox CRM, the central entity is the event of encountering, excavating a site, and this is done under the responsibility of a person. As usual, in the Cydox CRM, each entity is associated with an identifier, a type, preferably from a standard repository, and possibly an appellation. The identifier is generally the inventory number assigned during recording and provides a unique identifier in the dataset. In the case where a permanent identifier has not yet been deployed to identify an online resource, like ARC or Handle, it's this record identifier that can be used to access the resource. Each of these entities is also linked to a dating model on the documentation module. For the dating module, we should provide information on the period of use and of the element, excavation, site, artifact. A free date is indicated, a time appellation, which may be a number or a string. The literal date corresponds to the information as it was recorded end of the 80th centuries, for example. This period, sometimes fuzzy, is also specified by a numeric range more suitable for computer in the form of two separate records. For the documentation module, the aim is to link the documentation of these elementary archaeological elements, photographs, field drawing, recording sheets, archival documents, bibliographical references, operating reports, and so on. This documentation may itself be dated and associated with an author. To bring data to the semantic web and ensure its interoperability, we encourage data providers of the Open Archeo platform to use standard compliant repositories used by the archaeological community. For all typology, type of operation, type of structure, type of stratigraphic unit, artifact material, we use the multilingual thesaurus subjects of the PACTOBS, which is an ISO standard, managed by the Frontic network, increasingly used by French archaeologists. As part of the European Ariadne program, a part of the PACTOBS thesaurus are aligned with the control vocabulary of the Getty Museum Arts and Architecture thesaurus. The PACTOBS consider integrating the backbone thesaurus from the DARIA infrastructure. Web application has been implemented within the MASA consortium to help align instructors and poorly structured vocabulary with the standards of thesaurus. This application is called Open Termaline and provides an output SCOS file of the aligned vocabulary, as well as a file to submit to the PACTOBS administrators the terms to be added to enhance the PACTOBS thesaurus. In order to ensure the interoperability of vocabularies, we favor the association of permanent identifier, ARC or HANDLE, with the aligned terms. This is the case for vocabularies aligned with pactors, but also for chronological periods that we align with the Ariadne thesaurus submitted in Periodo. For localization, within a federated search platform such as OpenRKO, it did not seem relevant to us to localize the elements more precisely than this is the level of the one who is in the GeoNames database. In the case of GeoNames, the ARC identifier is not provided, but only array with a number identifying the geographical entity. The user-friendly interface provides a list of available data sources to start with. The user selects the ones he wants to query. In our prototype, we currently have only two data sources, but others are in preparation, such as Kitchen, and we are open to any submission to increase the resources and improve in OpenRKO. We divide the intuitive visual query interface of OpenRKO based on the generic model and by following the main visual guidelines chosen by ResearchBase, to the best of our knowledge, the only existing comparable visual querying tool. ResearchBase is developed at the British Museum on the basis of CIDOC-CRM with the aim of connecting researchers, data, and practices. Inspired by this model, a system of icons has been set up to identify the main components of the archaeological data, the site, the operation manager, the archaeological structure, the archaeological features, the walls, the burials, the stratigraphic units, and the archaeological artifacts. We start by selecting the entity for which we want to get the answer. Here I'm interested in burial, for example. Then OpenRKO suggests either questioning directly the criteria of these burials as is dating or investigating entities directly related to the burial entities. Then, when users wish to connect the two elements, burial and site for example, the interface automatically suggests the available relationship between these two elements. Here it's funding. This enables users to formulate their request in a simple way without having to know either the entities and properties of CIDOC-CRM or the structure of the system. We can then either search for an entity by its appellation or continue to associate other entities. The appellation search is done by dynamically drop down list of available occurrences. Here I have selected the archaeological site of Marmoutier. But we can also decide to focus our question on a criterion carried by another entity. Here I'm interested in person who have been in charge of the excavation. And the person I'm especially interested in is Elizabeth Lawrence. Well, that's it. My request is built. It looks like a sentence that is readable and understandable by an archaeologist and even by ordinary people. The structural queries that correspond to the sentences visually built by users are automatically computed. Thus, the user does not need to know the underlying model of the SparkQL query language. The result of the query can be displayed in several ways. Here a table giving the URI linking to the online resource. In the case of sites being queried, it's possible to display the result as a map. By clicking on the URI of the result, the users open the online page of the resource and can consult its details and specificities. Here's the burial number 2 from the excavation of Marmoutier carried out by Elizabeth Lawrence. OpenRKO is able to integrate several external thesauri that are useful for querying excavation datasets. Currently, it enables a user to formulate the queries with the vocabulary collected in the pactol thesaurus. It's also possible to use GeoName for spatial searches and Periodo for temporal researches, as shown on these two examples. Enabling a user to explore data settings integrated with OpenRKIO is of primary importance. To go further, the Linked Open Data Cloud currently exists for developers to build innovative applications based on the published linked datasets. The full potential of the CYDOC-CRM integrating capabilities is not necessarily limited to the visual querying provided by OpenRKIO. And to make it usable in other ways by everyone, we also provide tools for application to query the dataset via the integrated access point implemented by OpenRKIO. In this way, programs in Java, PHP, Python, and so on can use OpenRKIO Sparkle endpoint to automatically compute statistics on the participating datasets, or verify periodically the updates in datasets, and more generally perform any queries that could be built in the user interface. As example for users, we provide so many simple queries that can be processed through the interface. So OpenRKIO enables experienced user to interactively explore the dataset with their own SparkQL query. The system provides users with several kinds of visualization tools for the results they get from their queries. The standard visualization is a table of results. In the results of if the results are geolocalized, the site, they can be shown in a map. Google Chart can be used for statistical views, and so on. To conclude, OpenRKIO is designed to be extendable and reusable in other contexts. It has the advantage of being flexible. In particular, it's easy to extend the system with new data providers. The prototype can be tested in its current state with two French datasets provided by the LAT, ARSOL and AIRBA. And in the near future, we will extend OpenRKIO to the consultation of textual documentation and preventive archaeological excavations stored by INRAP and the French Regional Archaeological Services, and we plan to adapt and extend it to the European level as part of iNet+, and perhaps tomorrow with your data sets if you're interested in them. Thank you.